Nashville's Morning News with Dan Mance.
And so, my fellow Americans,
we talk news. Super Talk 99.7 WTN.
806, welcome on into Nashville's Morning News on Super Talk 99.7 WTN, along with Johnny B, Ken Weaver, Dan Mandis here. You know, Saturday was a big day for a lot of folks who just absolutely love Star Wars. It was May the 4th Be With You Day. Very, very exciting, where we can all unite in our love of the Star Wars. Yeah, nobody was talking about Star Wars this weekend. Actually, they were talking about Mark Hamill and his idiotic, moronic appearance at the White House press briefing on Friday. Did you see that?
Mark Hamill. Yeah, we heard it.
Mark Hamill comes out. If you folks didn't see it, if you haven't seen it yet, first of all, Mark Hamill comes out. He played Luke Skywalker. And he's got his dark sunglasses on, just like Joe Biden wears. And apparently, Hamill says that he just came out of Biden's office at the Oval Office, and Biden gave him the sunglasses. Yeah. And then Mark Hamill started to give us the BS.
I was honored to be asked to come to the White House to meet the president. The most legislatively successful president in my lifetime. Right. And, you know, I don't have to go through the list, the bipartisan infrastructure law, the PACT Act, the CHIPS Act, all of that. Inflation, 15 million jobs. Look, it's all good.
It's all good. That's what Mark Hamill says. It's all good.
So he was wearing shades, huh? Well, that means he's gone to the dark side.
The dark side.
Well, why wouldn't he? You know his dad is? Darth Vader.
That's right.
You know, my question is Luke okay?
Stupid, this one. Misguided he is.
Ask Jackery. listen again to this soundbite.
Sounds like Biden, he does.
So listen, he spends a couple of minutes with Biden and suddenly he starts slurring like him.
I was honored to be asked to come to the White House. To meet the president, the most successful president.
It's like the lies can't even come out of his mouth. And this is not only is Mark Hamill a professional actor, he's a professional voice actor.
Yeah.
And he can't get this out because, you know, he doesn't believe it himself.
The most legislatively successful president in my lifetime. And, you know, I don't have to go through the list, the bipartisan infrastructure law, the PACT Act, the CHIPS Act, all of that. Inflation, 15 million jobs. Look, it's all good.
It's all good, man.
Hey, Luke.
It's all good.
I'm your father.
Sounds like Hunter might have swung by the hotel and dropped him off.
Yeah, he sure did.
You know what? That would actually make sense.
Well, Hunter that day was known as Hunter Solo. His limo was the Millennium Falcon.
Biden was quoted as saying, "Hey, have you flown the Millennium Eagle lately?"
Yeah, you know, I did. I flew that.
He and Chewie.
Many people didn't know that. Yeah, Chewie hung out with me. A lot of people didn't know that either.
So he comes out gushing that Biden gave him these aviator sunglasses and he's wearing them. And he goes on and on talking about how great Biden is.
And it just shows you that one person can be so influential and so positive in our lives.
Wow. Influential and positive on our lives. Oh, that's Mark Hamill for you, friends.
Hey, Mark, it's been real positive on my bank account. Thanks. Yeah, buddy.
Got to go eat a lightsaber.
Please.
Oh. I mean, certainly, you know, listen, if there's one word that does describe Joe Biden, it is influential. I mean, you know, there's a man that, you know, his feebleness led to the war between Russia and Ukraine.
Yeah.
Emboldening Vladimir Putin to go into Ukraine with those weak sanctions.
Yeah.
Of course, we all know about funding Iran. I talk about that incessantly. So, you know, Hamill has been out campaigning for Biden a lot. And so one of the things that I spent the morning doing was going through Mark Hamill's Twitter feed.
As you know, the stakes in 2024 couldn't be higher. And so many of us around the country are counting on you to lead the resistance against Donald Trump and the evil empire that is the Republican Party.
Donald Trump and the evil empire that is the Republican Party.
Against Donald Trump and the evil empire that is the Republican Party.
Now, I'm not sure what Trump is. Like Donald Trump. Is that like a character? I don't think that's a character in Star Wars.
That comes from when somebody speaks while they're drunk.
Yeah, that's...
You mean like Mark Hamill?
Against Donald Trump and the evil empire that is the Republican Party.
There you go.
I think he'd been in the cantina too long.
Yeah.
You know what I hate about this, and I did mention this earlier, is that he's using Star Wars sort of themes and concepts to deride roughly half of the American people.
Sure.
I mean, he's allowed his opinion, clearly, as am I and Johnny and Ken. We're all allowed our opinions.
Right.
But he's bastardizing what Star Wars is. I mean, to me, that's number one, a disgrace. But the other thing is, it really is a rejection of roughly half of the people that love Star Wars out there, including me. It's a betrayal, really, of those people.
Almost makes you want to go to Star Trek.
All right, let's not go overboard, John. So, I mean, I would say promote your guy, but calling out half of America and calling us evil and some part of an evil empire is obviously BS. And it really, again, is a betrayal of those folks who made him rich and famous. There's another one. As again, I spend my morning going through Mark Hamill's Twitter feed, where he had a big picture of Joe Biden. And here's what he said.
Donald Trump and the evil empire that is the Republican Party.
No, that's not what it was.
Donald Trump.
But you know what? That is worth repeating.
Yes, it is.
Hey, I'm Mark Hamill, and I'm voting for Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Oh, Obi-Wan Kenobi.
God.
Like I said.
Good grief, man.
Oh, man, I'm
Alex Guinness
ill.
Is rolling in his grave right now.
Oh, man.
And I guarantee you that if Chewbacca heard that, he'd rip his arm off. Chewie, take off his head.
Good grief.
Yes.
For Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Obi-Wan Kenobi.
I mean, you know, he
can
just...
you see Joe wearing that robe?
No, he prefers to go naked.
Yes, he does.
Obi-Wan Kenobi.
He'd be in a towel.
Yeah, sure would.
Joe, he wouldn't be in a towel for long.
That wouldn't be in a cave either.
All right. You guys want to hear another?
Force is with me, buddy.
You guys want to do any lightsaber jokes, or should we just leave that alone?
Well, I was getting ready to.
Is that a lightsaber? You're just happy to...
Yeah, that's right.
Just moving right along.
Here's hey, Chewie, can I come sniff your hair? Got plenty to sniff.
Oh, what moronic.
Now, you know I drove a Millennium Falcon.
you know when Joe Biden was leader of the empire? You know why he didn't like the stormtroopers?
Why is that,
Brother Dan?
Well, they had helmets on. He couldn't sniff their hair.
And you know, too, Dan, when you would see Darth Vader, you know, they'd be putting on the helmet.
Yes.
And try to do it in private. With Joe, it's a little different, just putting in the teeth.
Here's more from Mark Hamill.
Ukrainians need our support more than ever before. Oh. Today is May the 4th. A symbolic day reminding us that good must prevail over evil and light must overcome darkness. Yeah. Let's continue our efforts to help Ukraine overcome this vile, illegal invasion. It really does make a difference. Thanks so much. May the force be with you and may your force be with Ukraine.
Oh, good.
May your force be with Ukraine. Do we all have our own individual forces? And boy, can I tell you what? If I had a force,
yeah,
I know what I'd do with my force.
I would too.
May the force be with you, and may your force be with Ukraine.
Ukraine already has all our money, so they might as well take the force, too.
Yeah.
I love, by the way, how he talks about, you know, the...
Let's continue our efforts to help Ukraine overcome this vile, illegal invasion.
How about the vile, illegal invasion of America? You want to talk about that, Lou?
Overcome this vile, illegal invasion.
No, he has nothing to say about that. There you go. Mark
Hamill. Hollywood.
Oh, man.
So.
God, what's he been smoking?
If you're well, it's the same thing that Howard Stern and Drew Barrymore have been smoking or drinking. The Kool-Aid.
We're lucky to have you. I know you'd be a good father to the country, and I want to thank you for providing a calming influence.
But in our country, we need you to be Mamala of the country.
One person can be so influential and so positive in our lives.
Well, influential, yes. Positive, not so much.
Oh.
So I'll remind those three and any other Hollywood celebrities that maybe Nashville celebrities.
Yeah,
that,
there's a few, you know, there.
Maybe listening. So Ricky Gervais said it all.
Right, you're in no position to lecture the public about anything. You know nothing about the real world. Most of you spent less time in school than Greta Thunberg. So.
There you go. Now, here's the deal, and I understand. I understand why Hollywood is trying to go to bat for Joe Biden, because his polling is down. A couple of headlines very quickly from The Hill. Depending on the polling, Biden is either in the worst shape of any first-term president since approval polling began, or nearly the worst. And this is from New York Magazine. The latest polling from Rasmussen on the 2024 presidential contest shows Donald Trump leading Joe Biden by 10 points in a two-way contest and by 12 points in a five-day race. In other words, the Democrats are saying,
I got a bad feeling about this.
And that's why I... Thank you.
Man, I hope Harrison Ford doesn't do this.
Oh, he will.
Oh, gosh, please.
Oh, I guarantee you, every Hollywood lib's going to come out of the woodwork.
Not Harrison Ford.
Oh, please, no. He will.
We'll see. I think if Harrison was going to come out, he would have done it by now. I would actually be interested. Harrison, he and I are on first name basis.
You know, Harry. I call him Harry. Yeah.
Communist propaganda and brainwashing. Thanks, Luke. You are not a Jedi to me anymore. No. Yeah.
Man.
You know, what's interesting, too, though, is, you know, when you hear him say the things that he said, I would actually understand him saying something like that in 2020. But we've got like an almost 4-year track record of Joe Biden now.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. But see, like Kim was saying,
yeah,
to Hollywood liberals, they don't know.
Yeah, man. They've got
they're
their
not going through it.
They've got their gated communities.
And their bank accounts are okay.
Yeah. You know,
they're fine.
You know, here's the deal. We all said,
I got a bad feeling about this.
When Biden won.
Oh, yeah.
We've known this for like 4 years now.
We knew what was coming.
6437 says it's reefer madness.
That's very true as well.
BC says I prefer Spaceballs over Star Wars. can't do that.
No, can't. Better not.
7381. 7381 says Star Trek is far superior. You know what I've realized?
What's that?
Is that every time I go to read the members nutrition super text line, I think
I got a bad feeling about this.
Anyway, there we go. All right,
Hollywood.
Hooray for Hollywood!
Spreading sunshine,
Hollywood, baby.
Blowing smoke.
Yes, indeed. And they come out of the woodwork when I remember when Al Gore was running. And man, they were calling in to the radio station nonstop because Al Gore was going to lose Tennessee.
Oh yeah,
and they flew them all in here, and you had Cher.
Well, sure. You can go have coffee with him and talk about, you know, gun control.
That's a good share, Brother Johnny B.
That is a good share.
And then you had Rob Reiner, which was even better. We're the most giving people in the world.
Yes. Mario says, may the farce be with you.
There you go.
Very good Mario.
Yes, sir. Right on.
Yes, so people are saying that Mark Hamill sounded like he was stoned.
He did.
Really? I don't even know if he was stoned. He sounded like drunk.
He said, yeah, well, it...
Or old. I mean, like he's had some issues.
He is 72. Yes, all right, let's listen to this one more time.
I was honored to be asked to come to the White House.
So he's slurring.
Yes.
You know what? Somebody like Peter Ducey should have asked him to do like a roadside, you know, drunk driving test.
Yes.
Ask him to walk in a straight line or touch his nose with his finger.
Yeah. Or blow in the, you know, the little contraption there.
Yes.
To meet the president, the most legislatively successful president in my lifetime.
I mean, they just...
And that's just absolute BS.
Well, that's the other thing. It's like Biden. It's not only it's the way that he's saying it, but what he's saying it. Mark Hamill's the same way.
President, the most legislatively successful president in my lifetime.
I just tried.
I mean, you know, I don't have to go through the list of bipartisan infrastructure.
Yeah.
What?
Boy, he said that well.
He said infrastructure.
Partisan infrastructure.
He did. He said infrastructure.
Infrastructure.
Well, you guys ready?
Yeah.
Infrastructure.
Infrastructure. I understood him.
You guys remember the infrastructure legislation, don't you?
Well, I do, Don.
Apparently it was bipartisan.
Infrastructure.
Infrastructure legislation.
Mark, I'm your father.
This is Mark Hamill, I guess, on drugs or drink. I don't know.
You know, I don't have to go through the list of bipartisan infrastructure law, the PACT Act, the CHIPS Act, all of that. Inflation, 15 million jobs. Look, it's all good.
50 million jobs.
It's all good, man.
It's all good.
It's all good.
Yeah, 15 million second and third jobs, Mark.
Yeah.
Right on.
Not keeping up with inflation, Mark.
It's all good.
It's all good.
Oh, it's all good,
jobs,
man.
Jobs were already there, Mark.
Yeah,
they were just coming back. After Joe shut him down.
You know, it's like they gave him a script. Well, yeah. It's the same with Howard Stern.
Yes.
I mean.
It's so good you're the father of our country.
Oh, gosh. Oh, man.
Anyway. That's what I really loved about Howard was the.
Yeah, how he's talking soft.
Yeah, he's so soft talking. And
guys, I've got to get out of here right at 9.
Okay.
Me too.
I've got to do some research into that. Infrastructure legislation.
Infrastructure. We got to look that infrastructure up.
I got to find that infrastructure legislation and try to do a monologue on it.
Yeah.
All right.
What's that going to mean for Tennessee? Coming up at 9, the Infrastructure Act.
Yeah. It's going to help with jobs.
They're going to build X-Wing fighters down in Chattanooga.
Hold on, Memphis. They're coming your way, too. Oh, man.